Pearen is one of our country's most loved pop sensations. Take a look.
At the dawn of the 90s, she was the fresh face of the 10 network. Back then, we all raced home to catch up with her as Toni Windsor in E Street.
Be in love all you like, but not with your best friend's boyfriend.
The fan favourite also enjoyed a successful singing career, earning 2 ARIA-certified gold singles. After a stint in the US, she returned home to host Australia's Funniest Home Videos.
I put together something.
Joining us live here in the studio.
Hello,
welcome back, Toni.
Thank you so much.
What does it feel like looking back at those fantastic clips? You're so talented.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah.
Well, it feels like another lifetime, but, you know, I mean, it's all part of life.
It is.
And now my kids get to see it. So
which is great.
They think it's all very bizarre. But, you know, I mean, it's part of who I am. And yeah. It's an important part of who I am.
So, absolutely. Yeah. No, I think civilization actually peaked in the 1990s. I'm one of those.
Yeah. Yeah.
All
for the 90s.
Yeah.
All for a 90s revival.
That's right.
Yeah.
Never went away. Okay.
You talk about your kids and that they see you there that much younger. How do you explain to them what you did?
Yeah, it's hard. I mean, you know, explaining your work to kids, especially in this line of work, is very difficult. But today I've brought them to the studio so they get more of a chance to understand what Mummy does and where Mummy's been and, you know, the life that I've had. Mm. So here I am.
Do you think the industry has changed much over the decade or two that you've been working in it?
Oh, I think the industry's changed dramatically. I think it was all, like, when I was a kid in the industry, it was much easier for us. We just went to work, did our job. But nowadays, you've got so much more to deal with social media and everything else.
Really? So it's got harder.
Tougher.
Yeah.
What do you make of the whole, obviously, there's been the big Me Too campaign that is in Hollywood and here. Has anything like that ever touched you? Was it tough for women, young women starting out in show business?
Yeah, I think young women need to know that they have a voice and they have rights and they can stand up for themselves and they don't have to put up with any kind of sexual predators or anyone that is going to make advances on them to advance their own career. They don't have to.
Was it like that in Australia in the 80s and 90s? Was it run like that?
I think it's always been like that.
Right.
And I, you know, and I'm so proud that it's starting to change and that women are understanding that it's not acceptable anymore and men are knowing that women won't accept it. Yeah.
And that they'll be taken seriously, that people will listen and take their complaints like, oh, okay, we will listen now.
Yeah. It's good changes.